experiment name is breakdown characteristics of plane point gap with HVAC. So in this characteristics of plane point gap with HVAC, we are going to see one effect called as corona effect. Corona effect is the main phenomenon which we'll observe here. So in this experiment, let us see the circuit diagram. Let us see the circuit diagram first clearly. You can see the circuit diagram connected with a single phase transformer connected to a 230 by 50 kilovolts 5 kVA transformer. It is a step up transformer connected to a plane point gap where the corona phenomenon is observed while conducting in the experiment. Now let us see the control panel. You have a variable input voltage, you have a AC charging voltage, you have a DC charging voltage. Now we are doing for AC, so you have a AC charging voltage. Next, let us see the mains on. You can see the mains on, mains off, HT, high tension on, high tension off. This is a unit ready. When your unit is ready, this will glow, indicates that the experiment is ready for conduction. I can reset my unit using this reset button. Next, door open. If your HV equipment door is open, it will glow, which indicates that we can't conduct the experiment. If your sample is tested and it is failed, then this will indicate. While doing AC, it should be in AC. While doing, it should be in DC mode. It's a memory. When you press this memory, I can see my breakdown voltage. And this is an emergency key. When needed, you have to do. This is an auto transformer. And these are the various gap distances versus breakdown voltages at STP, standard temperature and pressure. Now, let us start the experiment. This is a setup of plane to point gap. You can see a vernier caliper. You can see the readings of the vernier caliper. Now I have to set the distance between my point and plane using this vernier caliper. I am setting a distance of 10 mm. So rotate this back and try to bring it at 10 mm. Now you can see the gap between the point to plane is 10 mm. We have to conduct this experiment at 10 mm and it is connected to a water resistor. From the water resistor, a wire is connected to the HV transformer. So let us see the control panel, how this experiment works. When I close the switch door, your mains off has indicated. Now press mains on. So the unit is ready. Now HT is off. If I want to start my experiment, I have to press HT on. When HT is on, I have to vary my auto transformer till you observe a breakdown effect. You can listen the hissing sound. It's nothing but the corona effect. You can observe a bluish glow light also. So you can press the memory and note down the readings. You can see here the reading. At 10 mm distance, your breakdown voltage is 10 kV. This is your AC charging voltage. This is the breakdown voltage. This is my input voltage. Now, see here, your sample is failed. The meaning is, in between your plane and point, air is an insulating medium. It has undergone ionization process. And at one point it breaks. That point is at 10 kV. Similarly, you have to perform this experiment with the different gaps between your plane and point and observe the breakdown voltage. You can see, so this is the tabular column which we have to take up the readings. You can see that barometric pressure, room temperature. You have to note down the barometric pressure and the room temperature. Barometric pressure and room temperature. That is a pressure meter. It's Android barometric pressure meter. And it's a temperature. You have to note down the room temperature and... Now write down the value of the barometric pressure and temperature. Take different mm of distances as I have shown previously. Now we have taken an example at 10 mm distance. Do the sample for 3 iterations. Do the flashover for 3 iterations. First, second, third. Find the mean of all the 3 and find the peak value. You can see the readings and this is the model graph. You have to plot the model graph for your gap versus V in the peak. It will be a straight line. You can see the tabular column readings. At 10 mm, I have done 3 times the flashover. 10, first flashover, second 10, third also I got 10. So mean is 10. But I want to find out my peak since it is AC. So V peak equal to VRMS by root 3. If I want VRMS value into root 3. So this mean value 10 plus 10 plus 10, 30 by 3, I'll get 10 into root 3 is 17.32. Similarly, I have to increase the gap distance to 50, 20, 15, 20, 25 and then find out the values of V1, V2, V3 and Vmax. So next last part of this experiment is we are going to see how the charges will be discharged to the ground. Since we the human beings are a conductor, through the human beings and the discharge rods, we will discharge all the charges through the rod, through a human being, through a rod, through a human being body to the ground. It is done by a discharge rods. You can see the discharging rods. After the conduction of the experiment, you have to follow the last step, which is very, very important for safety purpose. You can see the discharge rods. It is caught by a human being, which is discharged to the ground. So the final reading values are taken and the graph is plotted between your V in the peak and your gap distance. You can see the gap distance 10 mm, 15 mm, 20 mm, 25 mm, 30 mm versus all the peak kilovolts. If you plot this both V in the versus gap mm, you will be getting a straight line as shown below. And from this experiment, we can find out the breakdown voltage of non-uniform fields. You can see a non-uniform field of point and plane where the breakdown strength at different capacities of dielectric materials is shown below.